Well, thank you very much. I want to thank Scott for his longtime leadership on these important issues. Thank you for always kicking this event off and for all the efforts that you've made with us over the years. It's really great to be here on what is now, I think, the 19th gathering. 16. I'm ahead of a little bit ahead of time.
Thanks.
16th gathering of this great expo. And I do want to just say a word about the Energy Efficiency and Renewable Energy Caucus. And we're going to be joined shortly by the co-chairman, Dave Reichert from Washington State, who is also a great advocate for clean energy and a great partner in this bipartisan caucus. The caucus includes 136 members of Congress from 35 states, the District of Columbia, and three United States territories. And what I would ask all of you to do is if your member of Congress is not a member of this bipartisan caucus, please reach out to him or her and encourage them to join. We have two signature events every year. One is this expo to bring people together to get a sense of the most cutting edge technologies that are out there. The second is an annual briefing that we do with folks from the Department of Energy and others to provide members of the caucus and others in Congress of where we are in terms of technology in the energy efficiency and renewable energy area. There are two folks that you should contact if you have a member of Congress who wants to sign up or encourage them to reach out to. That's Bill Parsons, who's my chief of staff. Bill should be here somewhere. There's Bill. And Ashley Johnson in Congressman Reichert's office. I don't know if Ashley's arrived yet. She may be with the congressman. So please see them if you've got a member of Congress that you think that wants to sign up to be part of this caucus. I do want to take a second to mention the other caucuses that have joined with us in making today possible. We are joined by the House Sustainable Energy and Environmental Coalition, the Congressional Energy Savings Performance Contract Caucus, the High Performance Building Caucus, the Green Schools Caucus, and the House Hydrogen and Fuel Cell Caucus. As you can see, you've got lots of caucuses under what we can consider the overall umbrella of the Energy Efficiency and Renewable Energy Caucus. I also want to thank Ken Bozog and his team at the Sustainable Energy Coalition for their great support in this effort. We've got about 50 exhibitors here today from all over. Please take time to see all the exhibitors. I'm pleased we've got a couple from Merrill, Standard Solar, Ocean Renewable Energy Coalition, the Diesel Technology Forum. But what makes this gathering really great is we've got people literally from all over the country that join us. So please take time to see what's out there. I also want to thank some of our speakers today. I want to thank them all. I'd like to thank Craig O'Connell from the Ex-Im Bank, Assistant Secretary for Energy Efficiency and Renewable Energy, Dr. David Danielson, who was here. Kathy Hossett, I don't know if she's arrived yet, from the U.S. Army's Energy Initiatives Task Force. FERC Commissioner John Morris, and EPA's Climate Protection Partnership Director Beth Craig, and others for joining us here today. I'm just going to close by mentioning two reports that I think caught the attention of a lot of people in the United States and around the world. The first was the NOAA report that indicated that atmospheric concentrations of carbon dioxide have now reached 400 parts per million. That is a milestone we do not want to reach. It's obviously an alarming indicator, and it means that we have to accelerate our efforts in the area of clean energy, and we need to do it now, and all of you are working hard in that area. We also know that with that challenge comes great opportunity. So we have an opportunity to help tackle climate change while also spurring economic growth and jobs and making us more energy secure here in the United States. Now, the Pew Charitable Trust recently had their report, Who's Winning the Clean Energy Race? And what that showed was that global clean energy investment is now at $269 $1 billion, five times greater than it was in 2004. So obviously this is an area where investment is rapidly increasing. That same Pew report also indicated that China was taking the lead in terms of nations involved in the clean energy space and the clean energy race. That China attracted $65.1 billion in investment in 2012 compared to $35.6 billion of clean energy investment in the United States. So while we all benefit from the efforts that are making wherever they are around the world in clean energy, in terms of jobs, we need the United States to redouble our efforts here. And I would say that I look forward to working with all of you, our colleagues, to make whatever policy changes we can make to help promote and support that effort. But in the meantime, you're where the action is, and we really appreciate your efforts, and this is an opportunity to showcase those efforts. I don't know if Congressman there. So David Reiner has arrived, so I'm going to turn it back to Scott, but just again, you were not here today, but it's been a great privilege working with you, and as I said earlier, Congressman Reiner has been a great champion, and look forward to his remarks as well. Thank you all very much.